you have a Honda that shakes a bit, you know, almost like it's nervous, it's shivering. Car is running okay, doesn't have a miss, has lots of power, no engine light is on, everything is fine, except when you come to a stop, you can feel this little shake to it. And again, everything's fine, the RPM is okay, everything's good, no engine light on. But the car is shaking, like it's shivering. You have that problem with your Civic? I'm going to show you how to diagnose it and how to fix it. Welcome to Car Questions.
Here's the kind of shake or the shivering that I'm talking about. If you open the driver's door, and I've got a bit of water on it, but you can actually put your hand on it and just feel it lots of times. You can feel it, feel the difference. You can see the water. You can see what it's doing? So it's not a thump, thump, thump. It's just a regular rough shiver, shimmy, whatever word you want to use. It's just like shivering. The engine's shivering. So we're going to fix this thing, and I'm going to show you what it's like after. The vibrations are almost gone. Still a little bit of vibration, of course, but they're almost gone. You won't believe the difference.
First step, get the hood up. And second step, if you see down here, and let's try to zoom in there. If you see down here, there's a block.
It's hard to see.
So there's this little metal protrusion or tab that's on the bottom of this, this piece of the top motor mount, front top motor mount. Take something thin like an old feeler gauge or tip of anything. If you can't get your feeler gauge underneath that, or you don't have a bit of a gap, and I'll show you what the, when we replace it, what the gap looks like, then you've probably, most likely, have a defective front motor mount. Although it looks good and there's no problems with it, this thing has sagged and this is giving you this vibration. So let's put a new one in, see what it looks like. Step one. Make sure the car is parked properly, the hood's open, and put a floor jack underneath the oil pan ever so slightly, just to take and bring it up to the oil pan, just to take the pressure off this joint. Because you're taking the joint off, you don't want the engine to fall. It will, so that's why you put the jack there. So you got to have a floor jack. Next, get yourself a 17 mil short socket. Get yourself your half-inch drive. I've got two extensions here, a short and a long one, and a universal joint. And get yourself a 3/4 inch socket. And if you like, instead of the 17 mil, you can use a 11/16 deep socket. But I'll show you where to use those. Also, get yourself a 3/8 ratchet and a 10 mil socket. And then we'll start. We need more tools, but I'll show you as we go. Okay, the first thing I want to do is I want to get this rubber dog bone off. This is in the way. We've got to get below it because the major motor mount's down here. This other motor mount is not your issue. So I'm going to take my 3/8 ratchet extension and 10 mil socket, and right down here on the other side of a big nut, you're going to see a ground wire, a little skinny thing, and it's a 10 mil nut, sorry, 10 mil bolt. So, just loosen it up. Like all good Hondas, the bolt shouldn't break, it shouldn't be rusty, it should come right off. So I'm going to take that off. Don't drop the bolts. Always that's the job. You can just leave that, push it out of the way, push the ground wire out of the way, and just quickly put the bolt right back in its hole so you don't lose it. Just put it in, and a few spins, and that's a good place to keep it. Okay, next, take your 10 mil ratchet, take your 10 mil socket again, your ratchet. There's an air conditioning line here. This is probably best if you take this bolt off. It holds a bracket for the air conditioning line, because you're just gonna wanna move this line a little bit to get out a nut down here. So this comes out. And on this one, Don't put the bolt back in. Just put it, it's hard to, just put it into a location close by. You're not going to lose it. And there you go. We got enough room to move. So now we're going to take out three bolts. We're going to use a 17 mil. We got one, two, three big bolts to take out. Now I'm going to use my electric air gun. And I'm going to use a short 6-inch, half-inch extension, half-inch universal joint, half-inch drive, 17 mil socket. You could use the 11/16. Let's get that on there. Check which way your gun's going. It's always a good thing. Put it on. There you go. Take that out. 15 socket out. Right here. One, okay, it's giving me a problem. Just get out a little more extra power. When that happens, I use a torque wrench. There we go. Okay. Maybe you should just buy a electric air ratchet with more power. Okay, so one short bolt, another short bolt, they're the same size, I can't mix those up, and if we're lucky, this comes out. Whoops, comes out three pieces. There are two pieces, I should say, that and that. So, just keep these out of the way in a safe location. This is the part that we're changing. This is the new mount. We've already bought it. It's about $58 in Canada. You can pay up to $300 for this, and if you have somebody change it out of the garage. But really, it is only a matter of a few bolts. So far, we've only taken out one, two, three, four, five bolts. That's it. So five bolts so far on the jack. Very common hand tools. Nothing fancy. Nothing high tech. Okay, so to get this out, we're going to have to take out another five bolts. One down there, one down here, one up here, and two here. And that second one requires a third bolt to remove a bracket. So let's get to it. Off a nut, off a big stud. There we go, the engine's coming down a bit. So we gotta saw it fall a little bit, so let's just pick it up a little bit, and there we go. So you've got the engine supported. Take that nut off, or that bolt all the way. Another long bolt, and that is shorter than the other ones and a different thread, so you won't mix those up. Then take out this bracket, put it in a safe place, and you're good to go. Okay, now we have one, two, three, four, five bolts more to go. Now there's another bracket right here. And what you're going to need for that is a 3/8 ratchet, 3/8 extension, and a 14 millimeter socket. And the first bolt you got to undo to get this bracket out is right here. And you can get to it if using a short extension. There's three bolts to hold this bracket on. And then the bracket will come off. Make sure your engine stays supported. Thank you.
careful not to flex the top of that washer bottle too much. But you should be able to get at it.
If you're worried, you can use a universal joint.
Same as the first bolt. This bracket hopefully should come out with a whole lot of trouble.
Seems to have some kind of clip on it.
Onto one of the air conditioning lines, so careful with that. I think we can just, for now, leave it there. I think it's pretty much going to be out of our way. Two more bolts and that mount should come out. And you can see this one is busted. That is why this car was shaking.
So, let's get that out. 17 mil. Half inch drive.
Use a ratchet,
or you can use what I did. Some kind of air tool or electric tool. Now, this is why a mechanic's best friend is a magnet. Get a magnet for the job. That separate.
So for this back bolt, I'm going to use a 3/8 drive, universal joint, 17 mil short socket with a couple extensions, and you just got to dipsy doodle around a power steering hose here and get that on, and there we go. Ratchet. There we go. Ooh, a little rusty on that one. Okay. Now, if you get lucky, just kind of fiddle this around a bit. Push that bracket out of the way. Should be able to get this out. Too much trouble. Might have to flex this a little bit here and there. There we go. And out comes the old motor mount. Broken.
Always look at your parts that you're replacing it with. Make sure they're the same height, same amount of bolt holes, generally the same shape. This one you can see is slightly different, but that doesn't affect its mounting location and its hole location, so you're good to go. But it's always a very good practice to make sure you check your replacement part prior to putting it in or taking it out. So, the process is the reverse of what we just did, starting with that last bolt, and away we go. So how many bolts do we actually do? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 for the dog bone, 9, 10. It's about 10 bolt job, not a big deal, and you're just using common hand tools, nothing fancy. So let's get this back in there. The bracket's down here, stayed in the car, and here it is. So you gotta get that back in position, because that's how it was before we got this out. So anyway, you might want to lower the motor a little bit on the jack to get this in, but you should be able to get it in without that. So like I say, Just follow the procedure, get everything back in. Now, it turns out I didn't have to move the motor to get that new motor mount in place, and just jimmied it around, got that other bracket in place. There's actually a little clip on it, but it just clips on, so no tools required. Now, reverse order, I'm going to put that bolt back in the bottom. They're the two toughest ones to reach. Here's an old trick that I like to use because, you know, try to get your hands down there, the things are going to fall in, and, you know, the bolt won't stay unless you got ones with magnets in it, and I don't. So, the best thing to try is get a Kleenex, serviette, whatever you got, napkin, and just put it over the socket hole like that, and get enough of it, push the bolt in, and just get rid of the rest of it, like that, and it should hold it. Should hold it in place, and you can drop them down. And clean the bolt off first. So you might need a little wire brush. Okay, after the job's done, you can stick your finger under that, under this little bump in the top bracket for the motor mount. There's that much space. So, just open your hood. If you don't see that space on your Honda Civic, you got a busted engine mount. Okay, that's it for sure. So that's one trick. You want to diagnose this quick. If that is right on the rubber, right on here, then you got a problem. You should be able to at least get, you know, a good portion of your thumb or finger under that thing. And you see how much space there is now? Loads. Before, couldn't stick anything under it. It was sitting right on it because the mount breaks under here, can't see it. All the other parts of the mount hold it really steady, so it's tough for a mechanic to diagnose. Okay, let's recap. If your Honda has a rough idle, or a shake, or a shimmy, or it's the shivers, there's no engine light on, and the car is running great otherwise, lots of power, everything's fine, fuel economy's good, and the engine looks like it's running okay, it just feels rough inside the car. There's a bit of a shake or shimmy, again, or almost like a nervous shiver to the car, then the first thing you do is check the space under that motor mount bracket. First thing, you find it down, replace it. Don't get new spark plugs. Don't get new ignition coils. Don't get a throttle body clean. Don't buy new fuel injectors. Don't do any of that. People have spent thousands of dollars trying to get rid of this problem. This car had, and it's a 2009, had 100,000 miles. In Canadian, that's 160,000 kilometers. So this car was running perfectly. And this is a problem that happens very gradually. The motor mount rubber separates and it starts to deteriorate. And it's very gradual until the point where you do notice it. So when you do notice it, you want it fixed. Don't fall for that other stuff. First thing a mechanic needs to do is check that gap on that front top motor mount. And again, the motor mount's about $58. You can pay up to $300 for them. Do it yourself job. 10 bolts, one nut. Common tools. All you need is a floor jack and a few hand tools, and you can do it in a couple hours, no problem. Anyway, hope this helps. Thanks for watching Car Questions, and please subscribe.